Good afternoon, everyone. Joe for JaspysHobbyland.com here. We are doing another case of 2017 Bowling Baseball, but this time it's a 12-box hobby edition, and this is a random team break. This is random team number one. The next one, as you can see, is already on the site. So for random team number one, big thanks to these folks right here. Thank you, everybody, for getting in. We do combo a couple teams. Mariners, Rays are comboed, and the Orioles and Marlins are comboed. Let's roll the dice and randomize each list 8 times, 2 and a 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and did I say 6? No, 8. 6, 7, can't count, and 8. So Ryan Stranko on the pole, and Randy in the number 28 spot. And we've got the teams right here, 2 and a 6 for the teams. 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8th and final time. Yankees all the way down to the Tigers. And here's how the randomizer shakes out for everybody. Ryan S., you got the Yankees. Gary, you have the Reds. Don Shockey, Mariners, and Rays combo. Gary with the Dodgers. Maybe a little Dodger Joe mojo. John Parker with the Mets. Will, you have the Rockies. Randy, last spot mojo with the Orioles and the Marlins combo spot. Mike Kuntz, Braves. Gary with the Angels. Randy with the Indians. Gary with the Pirates. Chad, you got the Phillies. Mike Kuntz, Diamondbacks. Charlie, you got the A's. Brent with the Blue Jays. Darren, you got the Nationals. Carter with the Astros. Rick T with the Royals. Kurt with the Cardinals. Carter, you have the White Sox. Chris Danielson, San Diego Padres. Eric, you have the Red Sox. Todd, you have the Rangers. Tim, with the Giants. Brent, with the Brewers. Richard, you got the Twins. Sean, Cubs. And Randy, Detroit Tigers. So there you go, folks. That was the randomizing portion of the video. When we come back, we're going to see if there's any trades, and then we'll have the 12-box break. Stick around. We'll be right back. Welcome back, folks. There were some trade offers. There were no trades in this hobby edition of Bowman Baseball. Random team number one. 12 boxes. Randy with that last spot mojo. Orioles, Marlins. Good luck to Randy. Good luck to everybody. Big thanks to everyone for getting in. Good luck. And Colts go cornerback. Yeah. Jason McKee's like Colts decide to skip an O lineman again. Ugh. Yeah, I guess they're just like, we don't feel like protecting Andrew Luck. I would love to make it a flawless night, Ryan K. That's our last case of flawless, by the way. And our last two cases of National Treasures are also on the site too. We no mas after that. We'll talk about that. Well, that's all on JaspysHobbyland.com, folks. So if you want to get into some flawless, do it. There's only 16 teams. No, we're halfway there on that flawless football. It's our last case. Let's do it. All right, so for the hobby edition, one autograph per. So the jumbos, obviously much bigger, 3 autographs per box. That's what we've been doing lately. One more case left of that jumbo on the website, JaspysHobbyland.com. The hobby edition only has 1 autograph per box, but the Especial thing with the hobby edition is that they feature the orange parallels. All right, good luck, everybody. I'm gonna open up all these packs first. And then we'll fly through the cards. This break should also take about an hour, maybe a little bit longer because there's more packs to open. Actually, this probably will take a little bit longer, to be honest with you, now that I think about it. But it's all right, folks. We got plenty of draft stuff to watch. Hang out, talk, et cetera, et cetera. Did the Ravens grab Bowser? Oh, yeah, they got Tyus Bowser. Nice. Just like in the Mario Brothers games. A 6'3", 247 outside linebacker. Nice. And I've got something stuck in my eye. Wow. Bengals take Joe Mixon. Yeah, the Bengals known for their strict discipline. Taking Joe Mixon, the 6'1", 226 running back from Oklahoma. All right, box 1 of 12, hobby edition. Good luck, everybody. Slightly different pattern in the cards if you're used to watching the jumbo editions, but we'll breeze through these. Nice gold Josh Hader to lead things off. 38 out of 50 for the Brew Crew. That'll go to Brent. And we'll be randomizing these World Baseball Classic cards too as one lot. Paper base does not ship in this one, per usual. Now, Jason McKee was terrified that the Raiders would draft him. Well, the Raiders have a pretty strict rule regarding domestic violence. I think it's Fred Biletnikoff's sister-in-law or something like that was killed as a result of a domestic violence incident. Oscar De La Cruz, these aren't numbered, but they're short printed. That goes to the Cubs. And they hold charities every year for domestic violence and whatnot for women's shelters and stuff. So they have a pretty strict policy on not drafting people or hiring people with that kind of history. And then you say, well, what about that Raiders first rounder? Well, that's what everyone's thinking is like, the Raiders must have done their due diligence before they drafted that kid at the end of the first round. Paul Byrd, copper. They talked to Joe Mixon, though. They said he's, a good kid, but I don't think a lot of teams were going to touch him. Luis Almanzar. San Diego Padres. There you go. And that is for the Padres. Sorry. Padres. Chris Danielson got randomized the Padres. And Chris, you're also going to get this one too. 18 out of 25. These are the hobby exclusive orange parallels. You got the talent pipeline. They do really have a good talent pipeline too. Especially Anderson Espinosa right there. And they got some young players playing right now. Margot, Renfro, Yangervis Solarte, who are pretty strong. So we're looking for low number parallels now that the first auto is out. Got some nice Preston Wilson. I haven't thought about Preston Wilson in ages. There's different color foil stamps on these, as you've noticed. If you look that up, maybe on Beckett or CardboardConnection.com, they may have some more info on the stamps and what they represent, like how short printed they are, basically. Oh, Sandy Alcantara, 54 out of 499, the refractor going to the Cardinals. That'll be for Kurt. The refractors for the talent pipelines are not numbered. And there we are at the end. So that was box one. Clinton Portis? All right. Well, Bengals picked up the controversial Joe Mixon. Now the Redskins are up.
I didn't know the Bills were in Bowman's vest.
Why is there a Bills card in there?
No, you put a football.
What?
Cowboys.
Uh-oh. Well, let me redo that list then after this break. They go linebacker Ryan Anderson. 6'2", 253, outside linebacker from Alabama. Gets to the QB pretty well, of course, just judging from the 20-second highlights that I see there. Buccaneers are on the clock. Then Broncos after that. Buccaneers pick is in, it looks like. So talk to me, folks. We're watching the NFL draft together. What is the what are the big name players that are left now? What are the big names that are left? My Raiders are picking in a handful of spots. Wonder what direction they're going to go. They could go running back, even with Marshawn Lynch. He's only around for 2 years. And, you know, Jalen Richard and DeAndre Washington had nice seasons last year, but it's not clear if one of those guys can clearly be, like, the number one guy, you know? So I wouldn't be surprised if they sneak in a running back, if there's one they like available at that 48th overall or something like that, 56th overall. All right, Carter saying Donta Foreman's still out there. See, these old school cards are pretty sick. They ship. Daryl Strawberry. Mitch Keller. There's Andrew Benintendi. We've seen some autographs of his. Justin Evans, safety, is off the board. Going to the Buccaneers. Buccaneers have a pretty solid offense going, so yeah. Seems like they're going to be shoring up that defense. Jason McKee says, wouldn't surprise me if both the Broncos and the Raiders go running back. I can certainly see that too. Broncos up right now. I realize I'm going through the paper rather quickly, but our shipping team, Axel Jaspi, will be looking at the backs of the paper just to make sure that we didn't miss any silver paper. That's out of $4.99. Chad Tracy right here, buyback. We'll sleeve those up and top load those and have those sent out to you too. If there's anything significantly lower numbered than that, we'll make sure that gets on camera too. We pulled a black paper Jake Lamb out of the last jumbo case we did, and I have to admit, it was we found a regular base card too. It was kind of difficult. I couldn't tell the difference, to be honest with you. So that's why we'll double check and look on the backs of all the cards. John Wetland. Was there really an E in his name? An extra E in his name? I didn't think so. I didn't know there was an extra E there. I don't remember one. Ooh, some orange? Orange Jose Pujols. Nice one for the Phillies. Chad with that one. 16 out of 25. Nice. There's your autograph. Rhys Hoskins, another one for the Phillies. 21 out of 150. Blue chrome. That's it for that box. Now the oranges are exclusive to the hobby, so the hobby boxes. So it makes the hobby cases so interesting. We have another random team break of the of hobby version of Bowman Baseball up on the website already. And our last case of Jumbo Pick Your Team is up on the website right now. So be sure to check that out. Is it bad that you want Raiders to go wide receiver? No, it is not. They have I think according to various websites, Pro Football Focus or whatever those data-driven websites are, I believe the Raiders had the worst wide receiver three in all of football. So they had problems with the with that slot receiver spot. There wasn't really anyone effective out of the slot. So it was just Amari Cooper and Michael Crabtree out wide. If one of them has a cold game, or if one of them gets the case of the drops, or if there's, you know, good outside cornerbacks, that would shut down that part of the game, and then there would be no one else to throw it to in passing downs. They had Clive Walford. He's pretty good, but I think he ended up blocking a little bit more. But now with Bennett with the Raiders as a tight end, that could open up that the sort of flats part of the game for one of those guys. Anyway, probably Bennett. But yeah, they could use the offense is pretty good. Even if you get, you know, half of beast mode, you know, I think that's still pretty good. Coupled with the younger guys like DeAndre Washington and Jalen Richard, and obviously Amari Cooper and Michael Crabtree still has a lot left in the tank. But they could use like a third receiver to kind of come up. Here, so my rivals, the Broncos. Let's see what they get. Running back. There you go, Jason McKee. Oh no, that's the person. Oh, no, that's the person reading. Jared Cook, I meant. Right, I wanted Bennett. 245 out of 250, Jared Cook, I mean. Purple paper for the Braves. So they go DeMarcus Walker, trying to replace DeMarcus's. They say the guy that J503 says, they say the guy that got last night might play some slot. Yeah, I'm not happy with the drops, that's for sure. Surprises we won as many games as we did. Luis Lopez, copper foil on that buyback. And there's your autograph. Purple chrome, Thomas Zapuki. 59 out of 250 on that one for the Metropolitans. That'll go to John Parker, who got randomized the Mets. Nice. We got Eric Fed. Blue, not numbered. Rookie paper does not ship. Zero paper ships. Anything chrome, though, that's not vet will ship. Yeah, I don't think, would you put, you know, a rookie who's trying to learn the league, new playbook, all that sort of stuff? I mean, hey, maybe if he's talented enough, if he's bright enough, yeah, you know, it's really just, it's, I'm not worried about someone's physical ability to play both offense and defense, but it's just a lot of plays and stuff to consume. You know what I mean? It's just a lot of work, you know? It's hard enough for someone like Terrell Pryor to go from quarterback to wide receiver. You know what I mean? Like, people don't realize how hard it is to do that. It's not very easy. So it just requires just that much dedication. Yeah, it doesn't happen often. He plays with a batting helmet in the field? Oh, no, he's a catcher. Never mind. I was like, wait a second. What is he, John Allred? Scott Spezio. Ooh, Cleveland Browns with Deshaun Kizer. All right, no other parallels? No, we got the auto. There we go. That was that box of hobby. I know, he beats out Brock for a job. Notre Dame, right, I think? Yeah, Notre Dame. 6'4", 233. He's a big kid. Kyle's like, poor guy, yeah. Well, I don't know. It'll be interesting. I know, you know, it's easy to make fun of the Cleveland Browns, but trading picks and doing all sorts of stuff and, you know, maybe not seemingly doing what people expected them to do, I suppose. You know, the front office is trying something new, kind of moneyballing it, you know what I mean? But although football is pretty data-driven in the way that baseball can be, most sports are, but it'll be interesting to see, like, once all the dust settles, you know, and you look at all of the Cleveland Brown picks as a whole, how that looks, you know? So it'll be interesting to see. Wow, four left in the mixer. Nice. Yeah, I see orders coming in. We still have a ways to go in this particular break, but yeah. I'm hoping we can knock out that mixer, maybe do that right after this. I have to squeeze, should have to squeeze in a dinner break somewhere, but we'll figure it out. We'll just roll with it, folks. We'll just have a fun Friday. Chris Bryant leads us off. Dylan Cease and desist, 267 out of 499 for the Cubbies. That will go to Sean. You got Joe Randa, copper foil stamp buyback for the, that's Kyle. I was like, what happened there? For the Royals. And Francisco Rios is your refractor auto, Blue Jays. That goes to Brent, 259 out of 499. All right, now let's see if we could find some low-numbered parallels here. Yeah, Booney saying he's a Cleveland guy. He's saying that, hey, well, eventually one of these QBs will hit, so it's worth a late second rounder. I agree. At some point, Derek Carr won the second round. Dak Prescott won in the fourth round. Someone's going to hit. I like Hugh Jackson as a coach, too, so eventually it'll happen.
Brady was a six-rounder.
And Brady was a six-rounder, absolutely. I don't think these are numbered. No, they're not. The 70th anniversary, but they're short print to a certain extent. Aaron Judge. And Stephen Hosey. Silver stamp on that buyback for the Giants. I see some orange down there. That'd be a nice parallel. Oranges are exclusive to hobby editions. Purple paper, Nolan Arenado, 85 out of 250. For the Rocks, Rockies hit going to Will Comstock. And it's for the Giants. Orange for the orange team, 12 out of 25 on Tyler Beedy. Nice one for the Giants. My rivals, Tim Langston. With that low-numbered paper. And there we go. That box in the books. All right, good luck, everybody. So my Raiders are almost going to pick. We got Lions, Dolphins, Giants, and then Raiders. Lions pick is in. So what do the Lions need? I forget who do they get in the first round. Lions got linebacker Jared Davis with a 21st pick in the first round, and now they are picking with the 21st pick in the second round, 53rd overall. Defensive back, Tease Tabor. Popping on that Lions cap. Kirsch leads us off. Start flying through these here. Is that orange? Yeah, it is. 15 out of 25. Reynaldo Lopez. Bowman Scouts top 100, number 52 on that one. And that's out of 25. White Sox. That goes to Carter. Love those orange parallels. You got blue Oscar De La Cruz for the Cubs. Those 70th anniversary ones, once again, not numbered. Just like this one, not numbered. Shorter printed, though. I don't have any more overtime eight backs. If I did, I'd be giving them out right now. But one day I can actually. Oh, nice. Refractor. 91 out of 499, Nick Senzel for the Red Legs. That goes to the Reds. That would be Gary with that one. The second overall pick from the 2016 draft. Not seen the autograph yet. There's Dave Hollins. Buyback, old Phillies guy. Copper. And wow, you are due to receive a lucky autograph redemption. That'll be randomized to one person in the break. You don't. I don't. I have no idea what's going to be in these lucky autograph redemptions. Looking at the checklist right now. Do they give us any previews of anything? No. No, just a mystery redemption. I don't know who it's going to be. But we'll randomize this to one person in the break. So we'll do that at the very end. I'm sure they wouldn't give you a lucky auto redemption. Right. I'm sure it wouldn't be like a Henry Owens, as Darren suggested. Right? Lucky you. Here's a Henry Owens. Ahmed Rosario, not numbered. Jason Tyner, silver, stamped buyback. Tim's like, whatever's laying around. I'm like, this will do. TJ Friedel, blue paper, 49 out of 150 for the Red Legs. All right, so my Raiders are on the clock finally. Who do you think the Raiders should get, everybody? Whether you're a Raider fan or not, if just a football fan in general, what do you think the Raiders should get? They went corner in the first round. Fixing up that secondary. That's, well, fixing up the defense in general. But Gary Conley, a bit controversial for him too. Although it seems like, I don't think the Raiders would draft a player accused of rape if they actually thought he did it. I think the charges apparently, allegedly, are flimsy. But I don't think they would have even drafted him if they thought that there was going to be a possibility that he would actually get prosecuted and maybe even be convicted. But a controversial choice nonetheless. Let's see what they do. J503, who has a Raiders logo there. I'm assuming he's a Raiders fan, as am I. Linebacker or D-line? Darren Porter says what? You want Tim? Well, they could use linebacker. Tim Williams from Alabama, they could use that. Well, Raekwon McMillan is out. Ohio State linebacker going to the Dolphins. And Dalvin Tomlinson, defensive tackle, Alabama. And the Raiders pick will be coming up. Yeah, NFL.com, the draft tracker lists Dalvin Tomlinson at 6'3". They give him that extra eighth. 6'3", 3'10". Yeah, well, it would be seriously sad if it was a false accusation. I think that's the weird world in which we live now. A lot of people, no matter men or women, you want 15 minutes of fame, right? 15 seconds of fame, maybe. You want to be Twitter famous, Instagram models, prank shows on YouTube, all sorts of things. You want to just try to be viral for just half a second, be famous for half a second. You know, think about what happened with Laramie Tunsil last year. You know, sometimes there are genuinely bad people out there, you know, questionable moral caliber. Sometimes there are people who just get accused. You know, like it's. But once that accusation is out there, court of public opinion will lay down the hammer, and it just kind of sticks with you, whether it's overturned or not. You know, it seems like that, right, Darren? It does seem like we live in a world where it's like, hey, you're guilty until proven innocent. Franklin Barreto, is that gold? No. And we've got, is that Fred Bastardo? There he is. It's blue foil right there. It might be a shorter print. J503, Raiders fans, since you were 5, surprising a lot in Portland. But you have to compete with the Sea Chickens fans too, yes. I would imagine so. Oh yeah, the Duke lacrosse players is a great story. Well, the sad thing is that false accusations like that really truly ruin it for the people who were actually assaulted, were assaulted for reals. You know, Garrett Whitley, 65 out of 250, purple chrome for the Rays. That's the Rays Mariners combo team. Don Shockey with that, and that's really the sad part, because at the end of the day, nobody wins. You know, and then everyone thinks everyone else is lying every time. It's like crying wolf. We all know that story. About the boy who cried wolf. That's a classic. Orange. Brian Merle. 20 out of 25. Nope. Brian Mundell. Not Merle. Mundell. That goes to the Rockies as well. That's another one for Will. Bulldog fan with that one. Nice, gold, Carson Fulmer. 18 out of 50, gold paper. Brian Harvey, copper foil buyback. CJ Hinojosa. Autograph for the Giants. Tim Langston. There you go, Tim. Oppo Joe Motor. See what my Raiders are going to do. Oh, there we go. Obi Melifonwu, the UConn safety. Nice, 6'4". That's good size. 224, that's good size. Need that size out there. Compliments Carl Joseph back there, which I also like. I also like Carl Joseph a lot, but he's a little undersized. He plays well, but a tad bit undersized. And now you got a big... Nice highlights too. It's nice big 6'4 safety. I dig that. Raiders definitely need that help. Can he play up front too? Your J503 says linebacker and safety? If he can come up too, that's pretty good. I think he did just say that. I think Willie Brown did say that. Oh, Jason McKee's happy. All right, good. I'll take it. Now, Raiders really need to rebuild that defense. They got a couple of good two, three good individual players, but they got to wrap some more people, wrap some more players around. around that. He hit 11.9 broad jump? All right. Well, good, yeah. If he can play safety, move up to linebacker is when we need the linebacker help, too. Liam's asking, what's the difference between 2017 Super Break and 2017 Super Break Nothing But Net? Well, Super Break what? What's the first thing? Oh, MEGR Chris says he wanted Obi. Well, good. It's always nice when people are like, oh, I wish I had that player. All right, Texans are up next. So I'm happy with what the Raiders are doing so far. Patching up that secondary. Tetsuro Yamada, 31 at 250 purple paper. Now, he's not associated with a major league team. So we will randomize these. I'll randomize that to one person. The other non-numbered ones will be randomized as one lot to someone. All right, Zach Cunningham. Wow, he's 6'3", 234 linebacker from Vanderbilt. Ron Lacuna, Purple Chrome, 177 out of 250 on that one for the Braves. That goes to Mike Koontz. There's Johnny Cueto, Reds edition. Silver foil buyback. Austin Voth, 294 out of 499. Refractor for the Nationals. Darren with that one. Luis Lopez, copper stamped, buyback. And there's TJ Friedel. Nice TJ Friedel auto for the Red Legs. Gary with that autograph. Jose Altuve, purple paper. 209 out of 250. That dude rakes. That goes to Carter and the Astros. Delvin Perez, not numbered. And that is that for that box.
Yes. Oh, also, Danny, I want to let you know. Yeah, Daniel, it's a Friday, that's why.
All right. Next one. We're chugging along. We're almost there. Watching the draft, breaking some baseball and football talk. It's best of both worlds, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for hanging out with me during this long break. Appreciate it. Guys are keeping me entertained here. Appreciate that. As for the Raiders, going two guys in the secondary, one guy can play apparently safety and move up a little bit too. I'm excited that the Raiders are doing that, because I was a little concerned in the offseason, like they weren't getting any of those free agent you know, those free agent defensive players. So, but the plan is now clear. And the Seahawks are there. We get one more round tonight, right? We get a third round, I think. So we'll get to see one more pick for our respective teams. See, all these rounds are the real interesting ones. You know, I believe that's where the GMs get their money. Dustin, why do your points keep getting taken away? That question, among others, Dustin, is answered on our details page right there. That is a question that is definitely answered there. So check that out. And that's for everybody, too. If you have any questions about our rewards program, they're all there. They reset every week. Okay, next one. Here we go. And Seahawks, they go center. They did go O-line. Ethan Posick or Posich. I don't know. It depends on how Balkan you want to go with that name. These cards are cool. I like these. But so it's always a little slower here since the channel is still a couple months in. But we're a late entry for now. We don't really start breaking the old. See, don't these old school cards, old school designs look pretty sick? I think these ship, obviously. Just paper base and vet base that doesn't ship. Well, Seahawks, I know we have a lot of Seahawks fans here. How do you feel about that pick? Daryl Hamilton. I did, Darren. I did start as a sorter here. But the intent was always for me. There's Alex Reyes. Nice. Poor Alex Reyes. Had to get surgery, but he's going to be a great one. There you go, Kurt. Yeah, I did start as a sorter for Jaspy's. 007 out of 150. We all have to start there. But that's for the Angels. Who has the Angels? Gary. But you know, I came on board with the intent to be on air from the get-go, but I just started sorting just so I could understand that part of the process. Brad Penny. Remember Brad Penny? But yeah, Axel has it easy. Don't feel bad for Axel. When Jason Jaspy, who's now doing Hockeyland, when Jason had started, it was just him. No help, all by himself. We were in a much smaller office. You know. And we were shipping like everything back then, back in the day. So don't feel bad for him, Darren. All right, four more boxes to go. We're almost there. And he accepted this job too. Darren, he accepted this job. It's not like we forced him into it. I And the Chiefs take defensive end. Jesus, 6'7", 289? Defensive end? See, this is why, if I was a football player, I would never want to, I would not want to be on the offensive side of the ball. Why would I want to get hit by a 6'7", 289-pound person? No. I'd rather do the hitting. But Tano Pasagnan from Villanova, 6'7", 289 defensive end going to the Chiefs. Cowboys are up. The boys. Where are the fans of America's team? What do you want to see here? I know, chasing after Derek Carr. Run, Derek Carr. Throw it, Derek Carr. Quick. Before this Tano kid comes after you. Derek Carr's not six. Derek Carr's like six, what, three? 50 pounds lighter? Something like that? All right. Tim Langston being a Chiefs fan, of course. Jason McKee predicting Auzi. Did I say that? I have to learn all these before the 2017 products start to drop. They need a cornerback. Yeah, they can use a little defense. Will they go wide receiver, maybe? I mean, Des Bryant's not getting any younger. Maybe later rounds, they'll dig someone up, but something to keep in their back of their heads. Jarlin Garcia or Harlan Garcia. Those blue ones are not numbered, but they'll still ship out to you, Marlins. Craig Lefferts. Buyback for the Rangers. And Eloy Jimenez is your autograph for the Cubs. That goes to Sean McIntosh. Yeah, there are some crazy names there. Oh, nice Daz Cameron, orange paper. 23 out of 25. Nice one for the Astros. Carter. Those orange parallels are exclusive to the hobby edition, so that's what makes them a little more especial. And two left in the mixer. Nice. I'm going to take a quick little break after this. And then we'll get that mixer going. So Cowboys pick is in. Randy Milligan for the Orioles. Looks like a gold stamp on that one. Again, cardboardconnection.com, or I think Beckett maybe has they have a blog post or an article that has a breakdown of those stamps. And that's it. Three boxes to go. Drew Pearson getting booed right there. They're in Philly, of course. Of course he's going to get booed. Yeah, Tim, we're all coming over to play Mario Kart 8 on the Switch, by the way. Is it cool? I love Mario Kart. Oh man, he's really putting in their faces. I like it. I know. I heard about the NES Classic getting discontinued. I was like, why do that? Now it's like $300 on like a secondary market. I'm just like, there's no way I'm paying for that. But then I heard, I think maybe you told me, Tim, or someone else, that they're gonna make a Super Nintendo kind of classic version of that. And someone else said after that that the old NES games will also be added to the Super Nintendo games. So if that's the case, I'd be happy. I want to go, I'd buy that for sure. Oh, is that right, Darren? Nice. I caught a foul ball pitched by Nolan Ryan that was fouled off by Randy Milligan. Well, that brings a, here's an interesting baseball related question, everybody. How many of you have caught a foul ball or a home run ball? I have not caught a foul ball. I've not caught a home run ball either, but it was tossed, a home run ball was tossed up to me. I think Jeff Rebele hit a home run for the Dodgers into maybe four or five rows up, left field, Dodger Stadium, next to the bullpen. I think it bounced in a chair, on a chair in front of me that was kind of empty. It was like a random game. And it bounced over my head, I think, into the bullpen area, and it got one of the relievers there. I forget who it was, tossed it up to me. Yeah, Jason McKee called the pick. A woozy. Shido Bawuzi, cornerback off the board. Jason McKee. You have those minor league? Well, to get that home run ball that was tossed out to me, I did kind of box out a kid, Tim Langston, I have to admit. I'm not ashamed about that. Red paper, Phil Bickford. I think Darren Dreyford hit another home run to that area, too. I think the kid got that one. So it all evened out. I figured he had plenty more years to catch foul balls. There was another game where I sat kind of a little bit lower in the infield area, in right near, sort of behind home plate. And all night long, there were foul balls that were fouled back, and they would blaze right over to our section. There was like three or four balls that flew right by us, like literally hitting. And I was on the at the aisle, and it would hit like the railing that was right there, and everything. So. Or the steps that were right there. Didn't get any of those. They were going too fast, but nice. Freddy Peralta orange. 1 out of 25 for the Brew Crew. That goes to Brent. Yeah, I have it on right here, Jason McKee. I was like and Drew Pearson's like really sticking it to them by saying, hey, five champions, blah blah blah. And they were just booing the entire time. I didn't even hear the pick, to be honest with you. Because I can usually hear the pick from the TV that's out there, but I couldn't. They were booing way too much. Quilvio Veras. Copper stamp buyback. And there's your autograph. Thomas Zabuki. Pazuki? It's a dessert. 313 out of 499. A refractor auto for the Mets. John Parker with the Mets. So we have the auto. We've got two boxes left. Let's see if we got any low number parallels here. Christian Yelich buyback. Silver stamp. And that's it. So Packers take Josh Jones safety, and now the Steelers are already up. Oh, and the Steelers take Juju Smith-Schuster from USC.
Trash Juju?
All right, two boxes left, folks. Steelers, that's a pretty solid team. 6'1", 215 receiver from USC.
Wish you stayed in LA, but
my rival. So yeah, I mean, think about that, right? Kyle Kramer is like, oh my, Antonio Brown, Martavis, and Juju. It's pretty good, right? Le'Veon Bell in the backfield.
Yeah, one dude got reinstated also.
That's not so bad.
That one receiver got reinstated too, right?
Who?
Martavis Bryant?
Yeah, I thought Juju Smith-Schuster was going to go like late first round or something like that, but hey, good for the Steelers, more offensive weapons for them. They've got a young but solid defense, and you know, I know Ben Roethlisberger is getting a little bit older, but keep adding weapons for him. I'm sure that start playing like, you know, start getting number wide receiver 3 snaps here and there. I think the Steelers will go quarterback at some point in later rounds, perhaps. Might give that a shot. Looks like there's a trade. Do the Bills just trade up? Take that Falcons pick at 63?
Is that one draft the Bills guy who was wearing an OJ shirt?
Is he really?
And he got drafted. He was wearing
right, I'm gonna open up this last box too at the same time.
He was wearing the getaway car.
The Bronco? The Ford Bronco. That's gonna stick with him forever.
I wish I was old enough to see that.
I was like 2 months. I remember watching it.
It's a classic moment.
It's okay. I mean, I've seen the OJ versus...
There's two documentaries. The OJ documentaries are really good.
Yeah, I see that when it first came out. I was following it.
Because there's the ESPN one, and then there's the Fox, like, dramatized version one.
Yeah, that's the one I liked a lot.
Yeah, that was... Both of them are pretty good, actually.
The Cuba...
Yeah, he did a really good job, too.
I've had Jeremy there at the criminal justice.
Oh, yeah?
I don't believe in the jury system.
It's definitely faulty. All right, last two boxes means there's second to last box, and I'm opening up the last box, the hobby edition. We might have time to do one more of these Bowman breaks tonight, folks, if you want to do it. We don't have very many cases left. We have the last, we have a couple more random team cases left, but we have the last jumbo case up already. Yeah, Jason McKee, I'm wondering that too. Why the Bills traded up? Where do they trade up from? Like, how many picks did they trade up? I don't see. I don't have round 3 on my screen. Let me look really quick. They must have traded up a ways. Pick 75, maybe? I don't know what they really traded, to be honest with you. Anyway, a bunch of compensatory picks coming up at the end of the third, too. Yeah. Would they trade up for O-line? You trade up that much for O-line? Maybe they didn't think it would fall to them? Okay. Last two boxes. Good luck, everybody. See a little orange peeking out right there? So... Let's end this one strong. Thanks very much for watching, everybody. This was random team number one. We are at the home stretch. Two more autographs to go. One autograph per hobby box. And special orange parallels that we can find in just the hobby only. Got another case of the random team on JaspysHobbyland.com if you want to run this back. We have time for one more tonight, maybe two. And we have our final jumbo case available as well, JaspysHobbyland.com. That's a pick your team. That's our last jumbo case. 81 out of 150, Daniel Murphy, blue paper for the Nationals. Darren with that one. There's Lloyd McClendon, silver stamp on the spy bag. Dylan Cousins, 70th anniversary, blue chrome. Orange might be an auto. No, it's not, but it's Rafael Devers. Nice. 6 out of 25 for the Red Sox. Nice one, Eric. Love these orange parallels in here. I think they look really sharp. Nice jaspy orange. Sid Fernandez. Copper buyback for the Mets. And Addison Russell is your Bowman Ascent autograph. I was wondering where their auto was going to be. Nice one, Cubs. That goes to Sean McIntosh. And Christian Stewart at the end there. So Bills take guard Deion Dawkins, 6'4", 314. Big boy from Temple. That's who they traded up for. All right, and the last box. Clint Frazier, purple chrome for the Yankees, 130 out of 250. Nice one for the Bronx Bombers. That'll go to Ryan S. We got Ben Zobrist, orange paper, 24 out of 25. That goes to Sean McIntosh and the Cubs. There you go, Sean. Randy Tomlin, copper buyback, Pirates. And Taylor Clark, blue chrome autograph for the Diamondbacks, Mike Kuntz. 93 out of 150 on that one. Third round pick for the Diamondbacks last year. And let's see if we can get some parallels out of here. Some low number parallels maybe. Braxton Garrett. No, thought that was going to be a blue. These are pretty cool, right? That's Phil Rizzuto. No, Syndergaard. Everybody's watching that football. AJ Puckett. That card is gold. 2 out of 50. Royals with that one. Rick T with a little gold at the end. Brad Ziegler, blue foil on that 70th anniversary buyback. And the last bit, we're almost there. For Gavin Lux for my Dodgers. Gary with the Gavin, 71 out of 250, purple paper. Up-and-coming prospect for the Dodgers, first rounder last year. And the last bit, just this is just a refractor, not numbered. Brendan Rodgers, Lourdes, and a Michael Kopech paper at the end. And that is your break, ladies and gentlemen. That was a 12-box hobby case. Random team break number one from JaspysHobbyland.com. And we'll do a couple quick randomizers here. We got a randomizer for the lucky autograph redemption, whatever that may be. The you know what? I'm going to do one big randomizer. So the name on top will get the lucky autograph redemption. The second name will get the purple paper of Tetsuro Yamada, 31 out of 250. And the third person will get all the Chrome World Baseball Classic as a lot. You've seen them. They're Chrome. They're not numbered, though. And they'll be randomized off as a lot to the third person in this break. So let's go back to the team list there. So from Mike all the way down to Darren. Let's get him in this blank list. And let's randomize it. 3-1, four times. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So on top is Richard Sewell. Richard with the lucky autograph. Charlie, you have the Yamada purple paper. And Sean McIntosh, you will get the lot of the Chrome WBC guys. I think they're just Japanese and Korean players. But they're not associated with a major league team yet. But you'll get them as a lot. So there you go, folks. That was random team break number one from JaspysHobbyland.com of 2007 Bowman Baseball. This is Joe for JaspysHobbyland.com. We'll break with you next time.